one, Kyle, it's race day.
What track is it?
Brands Hatch. Come on, get up. We've got to go.
I feel so close to you right now. It's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love pours down on me, surround me like a waterfall. There's no stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now.
And grabbed that second place as they went into Druids Hillbend, plunged down to Graham Hillbend, the left-hander along the Cooper Strait, and Wayne Ryan, well, he certainly has taken off with this one. Guyver weaving in third, great start by him. Lee Jackson's first through from the second row, ahead of Kyle Ryan. Ryan Watson, Joe Irving, Taron McKenzie's got a good start as well. Was Ryan Watson did you laugh?
Cut back, he's right with him just about now, Jack. And I would have expected that. You know, sometimes you get where somebody can lap, you know, half a second, three quarters of a second quicker than the next man in practice, and they got pulled by a long way. In this case, that wasn't the case. The first three or four on the front row did lap almost the same time.
Incidentally, Wayne Ryan leading the way on the KRP Racing Steps Foundation bike. Can we just congratulate KRP? New addition yesterday. Baby boy born and already here, one day old. That's going to start him off in the right direction.
Yeah, congrats. And I'd also like to congratulate Joe Irvine. It's all right, though. They're only pride in today.
So the 13-year-old has gone down. What a shame for him. This is the battle developing at the front now, though, as we watch number 30 in the Brookhouse Garage Racing SP125 Honda of Raynham's Rob Guyver, number 13, right behind the lad from Lidge in Kent.
Yeah,
and that's Wayne Ryan leading the way.
Guyver positively pensionable compared to most of these lads. But you know what I like about Guyver? He goes about his business, doesn't get upset. He knows he can put the times. Yeah,
except at Knockhill.
Oh, you say it's going to be a three-way this any minute.
Look at this. Rob Guyver decides it's time to move through as they go into Stirling. So the championship leader overtakes the man in second place, and they're being hounded now by Kyle Wright, who's fourth in the championship and not that far adrift.
Yeah,
this is one race and a half we've got on.
Yeah, Guyver went up the inside of Wayne Ryan into Stirling's, but then consequently ran wide coming out.
It was brisk, cool wind here at Brands Hatch. Oh, Rob Guyver dives early towards the apex and through it. Can't make that pass stick.
And I think they're leading two, you know. Ryan and Guyver are going to have a little bit of bother. Well, any minute from the third place man, Kyle Wright.
You can already feel the burning blue eyes of Kyle Wright. Yeah. Just to set on them right now in third place.
And
look at that.
Ryan
goes way wide at Surtees. That gave Rob Guyver his chance. I reckon he glimpsed Rob Guyver's front wheel there.
Yep. Kyle Wright, the man then, number 77 on the RS Racing Honda. That's Ryan Saxby, puts a brilliant bike out there.
I think Wright's going to lead this because he got the double bubble toe down the hill there at Pilgrim's Drop, up Hawthorn Hill into Hawthorns. He takes the lead.
Yep, and not only that, he's got a real quick bike and he's only a small lad. Is Kyle Wright, and that, like I said, makes a big difference. Kyle Wright was leading the first. Here we go. Yep, he did get a double slipstream. Yeah. No, I don't know with that. Kyle Wright was going to win the first round of the British Championship here at Brands until he's made country mile in the front with about two laps to go, and then ended up the bike seized. I think a main bearing went. It seized and threw him off at Druids.
So Kyle Wright, who turned 14 on the 22nd of July. Here he is then, virtually a birthday boy himself, leading the way from the championship leader, Rob Guyver, and now down to third place, the pole setter, Wayne Ryan.
Yeah, and Kyle Wright's one of these lads who, for 14 years of age, he shows quite incredible maturity. You know, he isn't one of the riders, the young lads, that's going to make a lot of mistakes. He does seem to ride fairly maturely.
And here, look at this, once again, Rob Guyver, he's the master of those early apexes. He just hits them and carves his way the shortest route from A to B, James.
It's not easy to do, though, Jack. It's easy to go winging in up the inside on a bit of a wing and a prayer and then not be able to stop it. And if you saw Kyle Wright there, what he did, as soon as he saw Guyver up the inside, he ran it a little bit wide to the left and tried to cut up the inside, just waiting for Guyver to run wide mid-corner, and he didn't. So it's difficult to do. That was a good move by Guyver. Fairly kind of frustrating for Guyver, just to every time he gets in the lead, he's passed down a straight, never in a corner.
It's of course number 77, the bike that's actually put on track, as he's doing, having kind of stopped racing at such an early age and decided he'd be more fun to get a bike together for another rider. And look at the success he's having.
He runs a good team, does Ryan. He puts a good bike out. He's a mega mechanic, but he also has the odd run out and does fairly well.
Well, he ran out at Oakland. He qualified well, but he disappeared in the race in the rain very early.
Yeah,
so Ryan, Guyver and Ryan, look at the lead they've got. They've disappeared. Luke Hedger has pushed his way through to fourth place as we watch that move again from Rob Guyver. Guyver's not going to give up on that move, even though it'll mean he'll probably get repassed when he slipstreamed down Pilgrim's Drop.
Absolutely,
we've got,
yeah.
Luke Hedger, Jordan Weaving, Lee Jackson, Joel Irving, Taron McKenzie, Callum Bay, and number 16, Westwood. The next guys, Nathan Westwood from Rugeley. Kyle Wright leads is about to retake the lead. Shoot. Oh no, Guyver brilliantly pulls out to prevent him slipstreaming him.
Yeah, and that's the thing, you know, I get weird comes.
Wait, Ryan on the inside.
I get the impression, you know, and this is what you've got to do with Guyver, just for a lap and a half.
Oh, and there's Wayne Ryan diving underneath Kyle Ride, responding to Kyle on the Ryan Saxelby bike. The Racing Steps Foundation back into second place. But for how long? Not long. He goes wide. Oh, he got a great line, though, through Paddock Hill Bend. Chops off the nose of Kyle Ride.
Yeah, and you know, this is what Guyver's got to do. If he let these young lads with their superior speed down the straights get away for a lap and a half, I don't think he'd stay with them if they could break the tourney.
I've got to compliment Corbett on that beautiful kind of silver Honda there. It looks really traditional. He's got laps, perhaps, and he's going to be left behind.
And you have got plenty of time to see it as he comes past.
There's number 13, Rob Guyver. Brookhouse Garage Honda. Remember, he missed the championship by 4 points last season. It was the second time he'd finished second in this championship. He currently leads it by 20 points, but from the guy who's ahead of him now, Wayne Ryan.
Yeah, if you get a chance to look, there's the logo RST emblazoned across the backside of Rob Guyver there. They make the leathers that he's wearing. I've got some exactly the same. Good stuff, full of body armour. I've tested him a couple of times myself.
Kyle Ride is still there, number 77, hovering in third place, threatening Rob Guyver in second, and another back marker ahead of this trio. Jump on Wayne Ryan. Ryan's starting to make one or two errors. Rob Guyver's took right in behind him. He'll go for the tight line into. He does, as he's done before, into Surtees.
Get it stopped, get it turned. The trouble is, he doesn't drag a lot of speed out of that corner, which means that the smaller boys with the quicker bikes and look.
Going to come back,
yeah. He's got to get tucked in behind Wayne Ryan now, get everything. Wayne Ryan should have cut to the inside to defend and look. Oh, I feel Guyver. So sorry for Guyver now, I do. It's not over for him, though. It's not over. He's
no, he's going
to
again, taking that tight line on Kyle Ride as they go down to Westfield. But at the moment, it's Wayne Ryan and Kyle Ride. The teeny boppers have the advantage over title leader Guyver.
Guyver doesn't need to waste time getting past Kyle Ride, otherwise he's not going to have a short game past Wayne Ryan.
So as they come round now, can he tuck in as they go into Stirlings? He's done it before. Kyle Ryan goes on the wide line, but he doesn't have a chance. There's no room there. Wayne Ryan, Racing Steps Foundation, the kid in the lead from Lydd in Kent, right behind him, the Nottinghamshire boy, Kyle Ryan. Third place at the moment for Raynham's Rob Guyver, and it looks as if Wayne Ryan, oh, but how fast is that bike of Ryan Saxelby as he drops him to the line? And Kyle Ryan grabs the advantage by a bike length across the line from Wayne Ryan. Garage bike. There's number 977, Kyle Ride. Look at those eyes. That guy has got. That kid looks like he means business. Started racing Minimoto when he was six, James.
Yeah, a lot of the Minimoto lads are coming through. But I tell you what, this is all going to be tempered by the fact that it's quite a community, this little 125 paddock, you know. And
a race winner. Well, Kyle Ride, another superb performance by you. And coming off that last corner, at what point did you think, I've got this?
Well, Wayne...
Actually, did you think I've got this at all?
I did think I got it a little bit, because I knew I had a slipstream of mine and Wayne bikes that are around the same, so, yeah, it was superb.
Anything you can take from this one on to the next race? Anything you've learnt out there today?
Yeah, I've learnt loads of things from Rob, braking later, from Wayne, corner speed and everything, so it's great. And I'd just like to thank all my sponsors, Shark, everyone on my levers, Ryan, Alistair especially, and my dad.
Is the champagne being sprayed by Kyle Ryan after that fantastic 125 GP race out there? Kyle Ryan just pipping Wayne Ryan over the line. Fractions of a second there may have been between them, but the riders will take a win no matter how it comes. Rob Guyver just suffering.
To live our life. Hands up! King! King!